Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be talking about the Axos 8 by Haefely Hipotronics. We're going to walk you guys through a little bit about the overview of this test system and how we have it configured. Then we're going to go ahead and move on to show you guys how you receive it and how to set it up, as well as a little bit about the software and how to manipulate testing parameters. And then we're going to finally touch base on a little bit about additional testing considerations as far as accredited calibrations go, as well as additional testing capabilities should you guys need them that are out there as well. So a little bit about this test system. This multifunction generator by Haefely Hipotronics provides testing to a wide variety of immunity-based standards. This includes IEC 61000-4-5 for surge, IEC 61000-4-4 for EFT, and then finally 61000-4-12 for that ring wave testing to 7 kilohertz. So it does provide surge to 7 kV and then EFT to 5 kV as well. These are just how we have these generators set up. Again, there is a whole variety of other ways as far as testing capabilities go. However, this is how we have ours set up. All right, so take a look at our board behind us. This just talks a little bit about the surge, ring wave, and EFT capabilities, as well as the AC-DC coupler. And then there is an option as well as for additional testing accessories for the DIP-116, which is going to provide your dips and interrupts testing. Again, this is an additional testing accessory, so if you guys are looking for those capabilities, you can go ahead and rent that in addition to the test system itself. So that's a little bit about this Haefely Hipotronics immunity generator. So why don't we go ahead now and we'll take a look at how you guys receive the equipment, and then we'll walk you through setting it up and then going through the interface and modifying some testing parameters. All right, let's get started. Here you'll find your Axos 8. This portion of the video is going to show you how to connect all the wires, and it's also going to show you a little bit about the on-screen software you can access right here through the front panel. All we've done so far is remove this piece of test equipment from its Pelican case, which just protects it in shipping, and we've also plugged in the power cord to the piece of equipment on the right side. You can see it over there. A couple of things you're going to get with this piece of test equipment. You're going to get this little black folder right here. That's going to have your calibration documentation. All of our EMC test equipment is calibrated, so you guys can know that you are getting a piece of test equipment that has been calibrated. All right, you also find the user manual right here, and this is going to provide you with that basic information about this piece of test equipment. Also go into more detail as well. Should you guys have any questions or maybe not be familiar with this piece of test equipment, it's in there with it. So just so you guys are aware of that. You also find two bags of cords right here. These cords are going to provide you with all kinds of good stuff you're going to need to do some testing. So we'll set these right here for now. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're actually going to plug in power to the coupler. So as I mentioned before, the coupler is built into this piece of test equipment. So we've got to be sure that if we are going to utilize it, that it is plugged in. So it has three cords, pretty straightforward there. Ground, neutral, and your line. So you just go ahead and plug those in back. All right. Now, your output from your coupler, same concept here, three cords, just goes right here to your line, neutral, and your ground. And this is going to just plug in directly to your equipment under test and allow you to conduct testing. All right, we're not going to do any testing today though, so we're just going to set this on the side over here. All right, so now we're going to take a minute here. We're going to walk through some of the front panel here on the front side of this Axos 8. We're going to start from our left right here and work our way right. This is pretty straightforward right here. This is the power button. Working our way here, you'll see the voltage, surge voltage, the surge current, followed by your dips voltage and your dips current. All right, so working our way now to this middle section right here. This is your direct surge. So that's not coupled. And you'll find our burst right here. And then you'll find our coupling output on the far right here. All right, so that's just a little bit about the front side of it. Some other things you guys should be aware of that you guys will be seeing as well is software. So this little USB drive right here, that's gonna have all the software. So should you guys not wanna control it via front panel, but through a computer, that is available for you guys as well. All right, so I think we walked through most of the front here. Let's go ahead and turn it on and take a look at the screen. All right, here you'll find the home screen for our Axos 8. You'll see surge, EFT, burst, voltage dips, magnetic field, and ring wave. So we're not going to really concern ourselves too much today with magnetic field or voltage dips testing. we're going to take a look at the surge in ring waves. So let's take a look at the surge here. You see a whole gamut of different parameters you can easily adjust. So let's say you want to adjust the peak voltage from 6 kV. Let's say you want to adjust it to 1 kV. What you got to do is hit the back button, 1 kV, select OK, and then it saves it right on the screen. So one thing to consider is definitely how you're coupling. So with different testing standards require different methods of coupling. So you'll see up here, you'll see IEC and then ANSI. So you can just go ahead and toggle back and forth there. Easy way to change that. So we're not gonna mess with that too much today. All right, so that's pretty straightforward there with the surge. Let's go ahead and take a look at the ring wave real quick. All right, so there's a waveform right there, kind of going across the screen. You can adjust the impedance right there from 12 to 30 and so forth. You'll find the same kind of setup as the surge. You can adjust the testing parameters right here. So number, repetition rate, all kinds of stuff there for you. So again, as I mentioned before, one of the cool things about this test equipment really is this interface here. Really makes it easy to use, gets testing done very quickly. All right, so let's go ahead and let's talk a little bit about some additional considerations and do a quick conclusion. We're gonna talk briefly about the testing capabilities of this Axos 8. Obviously, we have them configured for surge, EFT, and ring wave. There's also other configurations out there. So if you guys are looking to take advantage of that, you guys go out there and either rent it from us, or you can reach out to Haefely Hipotronics. I know they have some great guys out there. Cameron's amazing. And they'll be able to provide you with some more information as far as this piece of test equipment, as well as accessories to supplement your testing capabilities. So I know that we mentioned the DIP116 earlier, which is that 61000-4-11 dips and interrupts supplemental test equipment or test accessory. So you guys can go ahead and check that out too. We do run them for as short as a week and as long as you guys need them for. So feel free to drop us a line too if your needs a little more immediate. We hope you guys learned a little bit, and we look forward to hearing from you guys soon.